and your healing. Now let's look at this from a spiritual point of view. If truth is the stitch that closes the wounds left from childhood hurt and trauma, what are you sewing yourself up with? For me, my healing process after surgery is a direct reflection of healing the little girl inside of me. While I went through surgery to correct something, the outcome was very painful. But after I dealt with the pain, I am doing fruit. Spiritually, healing may hurt. When you excavate old troubles and you bring up old stuff that you've been talking about in 20 years, it can cause pain. But by exposing your pain to God's truth with the help of the Holy Spirit, He will allow pain to deteriorate, just like the victims who were fossilized in propane. Once they were unmarried, the wind and the air deteriorated them. And if you know anything about the Holy Spirit whispers coming up next. So I don't know what you're talking about, but that's my point. He's my friend, but that's like a dad, so I don't know. But anyway, the Greek word Holy Spirit, for spirit is new, and it means wind. So we gotta get some wind in the spirit. Oh, fossilized person, right? So after thinking about all this, it's a fact that I experienced some hurts during childhood. But the truth is, God is always working everything out for my good. Because I'm fearfully and wonderfully made. And it's a fact that I believe the spirit of rejection settled on me when I was in my mom's womb. The truth is, God knit me together to be right there in her womb on purpose and for purpose. And his angels sang over me before they sent me here on May 8th, 1976. I was not a mistake.
Kim's way, but I wanted to make sure I did it his way.
So I knew that I was going to actually share the stage with somebody. He gave me that. But I was like, I'm going to share the stage with someone. It's going to be amazing. Thank you, Lord. And he was like, you got to go down to the crowd. It's important because sometimes when we're in the crowd, we so worried about what everybody's looking at. Okay, you got to pick that up really late. But we're so worried about what people are looking at, what they're going to say. If I tell the truth, they will know. And so the crowd, we usually what? When we live in, we do it quiet. But not today. Because we can keep. You can play if you want to. You can look cute and not say that if you want to. But that's not what we're here for. God will call on us to save souls. And so I say that you leave here with the same junk you walked in here with. Right? Because I ain't going to hell for you. I mean, y'all, I love it. Most of everybody in here. But I ain't doing it.
Her dad should my grandparents, you know, if I don't have a phone count, they should go see me. I thought that I would have a sense of normalcy at that time, living with my grandparents. But then I had to go through the verbal abuse of my grandmother before we all cried like your mom, she called me out. I didn't know my cousin was going to be the other day. And her mom, and then it took us to aunt somewhere. I went from grandparents to another one of my mom's house. Grandparents, but your mother is not supposed to be a crack. She was not there when I started the religious cycle. I didn't have my mother there to tell me the importance of keeping my virginity, so I lost it at the age of 13. She wasn't there for my junior prom, my senior prom, she wasn't there. She was there for my high school graduation, but you know how she chose to celebrate me. And I thought at 18 it was cool. It was all the joy together. My daughter's graduating high school next week. And she's starting college in the same week, and I'm so proud. Because I don't have myself to be a different kind of mom. And so and he's 20. He's so cool. I've been praying about him because I'm so afraid that he may try something heavy. And I told him 2 weeks ago, I said, God told me it was going to be a lot for the family. Mm. And he said, no, mama, we're going to be the light. Mm. I put my children in church, and I drowned myself in my classroom in the hair of my land that I smiled. He asked me what they were doing. He said, mama, why do you cry so much? And there's nothing when you say it. And I looked at my child and I said, there's a praise on the inside that I can't get myself. My heart's for you. From the depths of my soul. So excuse me if I'm seeming ill. Yeah, maybe even say. Role model in his life too, so
I'm still a work in progress. God's still working on me. Yes.
Jamel was praying for our group. And on several occasions, she kept asking me, what's going on with you? You know, in that Jamel voice. And I really didn't understand what she was asking. She kept asking me that. No. Me and Cheryl are running from her. And so the night that she prayed for our prayer circle, she called me. She's like, what is going on with you? And so at that night, I started just kind of pouring out and just sharing. I'm struggling with some things. I think it's rejection. It's rejection from constant. And I was thinking about it. You know, I was that little 17-year-old girl that was rejected because I wasn't popular. I always wanted a big sister, and I was rejected from my dad was married before, and I had a big sister, but her mother would not allow us to have a relationship. I was rejected because I wasn't having sex at the age of 17. I was rejected when I didn't know what love was, but when people move on, that hurts. You know, so you have to learn from that. So today, I stand at the age of 45, desiring my heart to be healed of all this hurt. That night, I was able to pour out my heart and started the process of reaching out to God in that area. That night, I understood that was healing in my pain. This is the night that someone saw the mask that I kept hiding behind. It needed to be revealed for me to move forward. So the process of healing and praying just for me to let go and not be in control is what I'm to believe in God's will be done for my life. I can't worry anymore that I'm in my 40s and not married, I'm having kids. It's God's time. So I would say to that 17-year-old girl, you are loved.
Yes.
You will be accepted by friends who love you and treat you like family.
Yes.
You will join a sorority and God will give you a lot of sisters.
Yes.
You will be part of a prayer circle where God will give you more sisters that will cover you in prayer. God will create a master class for the sister that will share your spiritual journey with you.
Yes.
You are pretty and you will continue to be confident. And he will give you the confidence to say and do what you need to do. The temporary hurt is just that. It's temporary.
Yes.
God has a plan for your life.
Yes.
Your husband is on the way.
Yes.
Trust God's process to him.
Yes.
If you're dealing with rejection, just be reminded, Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. And there's one more.
Didn't have and look at what you have in front of you.
say it before I can say that God blessed me with a man that I love so much today.
Amen.
And sometimes you meet people and you're not looking for them,
but they're there for a reason.
God gave me a man as a provider. He's my friend. He's my prayer warrior. He's my supporter when I need for myself. And so often we take these for granted. But the same thing is also locked to our door. And I look at the relationship he and I have. Sometimes I can tell you, I can tell that relationship, I didn't have it. But then I go back to that prayer that they told me. And she's like, God is filling your void. You don't realize that he's giving you things that you felt like you didn't have. And sometimes you never know what package is going to come in or where it's going to come from. But he's going to fill that void for you. And he fills that void by providing you with a man that loves me unconditional. That loves me for who I am. And I can trust my heart with him. I'm letting the intimate go. Those of you that know me know I am a strong group, but I let it go, and each day I learn more and more. But having grown up in a situation that is a single parent home and having it for yourself, I'm learning that it's okay to ask for help. It's okay to have someone to lean on and to support and carry you. Every day is a new challenge, but I'm learning and I'm letting go. But I forgive it. My father for the wrongs that he did. And maybe he didn't know what he was doing. I'm going to give my half sister to walk around to be happy. I'm giving her because she did not know.
Wanted them to know that they had support because it's okay to speak your truth even if your voice shakes. So I know that within this room, there's a woman who can easily get up and share just like Tamika, Charmaine, Tammy, and Cheryl. But because Jimenez is here and smells so good, I'm not going to do that. I also know that there are countless others who, for whatever reason, don't quite have the courage to stand up and vocally share their truth, even if their voice is shaking. So here's what I want you to do. If you have a little girl inside, and she's still a little broken, or if it's a grown woman and she's trying to get the healing, she ain't quite there yet, I want you to come to this makeshift altar. And I'm going to pray for us, not you, us. And if you don't have the capacity to get up and come right now, okay, you just stand with your sister in Christ at your seat. And you pray for us who need to be at the altar. Because that's right, I don't want you to be beside what we have. So if you need to come, come.
You can turn it.
Because it's time for us to heal as women.
put it back in her.